Hi everyone, my name is Kristen Sharpe and I'm a master's student here at the Virginia Institute of Marine Science. And for the next few minutes, I'm going to be telling you about my research on zooplankton in the Chesapeake Bay. So the first thing that we ask ourselves is, what exactly are zooplankton? Well, plankton comes from the Greek planktos, which means drifter or wanderer. So plankton are all of the organisms who cannot swim against a current and thus drift around in the water column. So you have two major types of plankton, phytoplankton and zooplankton. Phyto means plant, so just like land plants, these microscopic organisms use sunlight and carbon dioxide to create food and oxygen through photosynthesis, and they form the base of aquatic food webs. And zoo means animal, so zooplankton are all the animals who drift around in the water, from microscopic animals to large animals like jellyfishes. And some zooplankton spend their entire life as plankton, like these copepods in the red circle here. Copepods are actually the most abundant animal on Earth, which is a really interesting fact about zooplankton. Other animals in the zooplankton group spend only part of their life as plankton before they grow into their adult form. So that includes things like this larval fish here in the photograph, as well as larval crabs. So one reason why zooplankton are important is that they play a vital role in the aquatic food web. So zooplankton graze on phytoplankton, which keeps their populations in check. And then in turn, zooplankton are eaten by a variety of other animals, from larger zooplankton to fishes to even whales. So every animal that lives in the ocean, either directly or indirectly, relies on zooplankton for their nutrition. A few examples of animals that rely directly on plankton for their food source include filter feeding whale sharks, which are on the left-hand side there, as well as Adelie penguins, whose major food source is Antarctic krill, which is a type of zooplankton in the Southern Ocean. Another reason why zooplankton are important is because they support many of the fishes and other animals that we rely on economically and recreationally as humans. This largemouth silverfish on the left-hand side is called a bay anchovy, and anchovies filter feed on plankton. So they can be a direct food source for humans, but they can also be a source of food for larger fishes that we like to catch and eat, like striped bass and red drum. Shellfish are also filter feeders who feast on plankton. So on the right-hand side, we have a hard clam. All shellfishes, including clams, oysters, mussels, and scallops, eat plankton. So if you like enjoying a nice basket of fried clam fritters, you can thank plankton. And another reason why zooplankton are important is that they help to cycle nutrients throughout the global ocean through eating and ultimately through pooping. So you can imagine that this box is the ocean, and in the surface waters, we have phytoplankton. Now during the day, they use the sun's energy as well as nutrients and carbon dioxide to create sugars. Zooplankton, which are represented here by copepods, stay in the deeper waters during the day to avoid being eaten by their predators. But when the sun goes down, the zooplankton begin a migration up to the surface waters to feed on the phytoplankton. Then, as the sun rises again, the zooplankton move back down to depths. And just like all other animals who eat, zooplankton do poop. So they create what we call fecal pellets, which are chock full of not only carbon, but also nitrogen and phosphorus, which are really important nutrients in the ecosystem. So these pellets are heavy, so they sink down into the bottom waters, where they can be used or eaten by other organisms, or if they make it all the way down to the bottom, they can be buried in the seafloor sediments, where they can remain for hundreds to thousands of years. And we call this process the biological pump. So it transports carbon from the atmosphere into the deep sea and into the sediments. And without the biological pump, we would have up to 50% more carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, which is important because carbon dioxide is one type of atmospheric gas that contributes to climate change. So now that we know what zooplankton are and why they're important, I'm going to tell you a little bit about my research. So I'm studying the types of zooplankton that we have in the Chesapeake Bay and how much carbon they help to remove from the atmosphere. So this is my sample site here. I'm sampling in the York River, which is right outside of the Virginia Institute of Marine Science, and it's a large river that drains into the Chesapeake Bay. So there's two parts to my research, sample collection and also lab experiments. So I collect specimens. I go out once a month in the York River, both at day and at night, and I collect specimens using a zooplankton net, which is like a large mesh funnel. So we drag this net behind the boat. Water enters through the opening and passes through the mesh while zooplankton are trapped on the mesh. And then they pass down the mesh and into a bottle at the end called a cod end, which I then collect and then some of it I preserve in a jar with formaldehyde, and I then identify which animals are there and how many of them there are using microscopes. And for my experiments, I'm performing fecal pellet production studies. So basically, I hold a couple of zooplankton in a plankton prison, I like to call them, their jars, where they're separated in an inner jar. And the bottom of the inner jar has mesh, which keeps the animals on the inside of the inner jar. And then what happens is as they're feeding, they're creating these fecal pellets, which are heavy. So they sink down into that outer container where I can then collect them and process them to find out how much carbon is in them. Now, this is kind of what it looks like when I collect them. So you can see the fecal pellets here in this red circle, and they're this nice green color because they're full of phytoplankton, which the copepods or other zooplankton have been eating. So using what I learn about which animals are out there in the Chesapeake Bay and how fast they're cycling carbon, I can determine how fast this carbon is actually being cycled through the Chesapeake Bay. And this information is very important in making models to help combat the climate change impacts by making decisions on how to limit our carbon dioxide emissions. And with that, I'd really like to thank my advisor and my lab mates in the Zooplankton Ecology Lab at the Virginia Institute of Marine Science, as well as my major funding sources, which are the National Science Foundation, the Commonwealth of Virginia, and the Kelly Watson Fellowship. Here's some of my contact information. I'm happy to answer questions that you may have about my research or zooplankton in general. And if you'd like to stay in the know about upcoming VIMS events and the latest research that we're doing here, please subscribe to eTidings, which is our monthly e-newsletter. Thanks for listening, and I hope to see some of you in person at future VIMS events.